Hola amigos de Wine News TV, seguimos desde el Fine Wine de Plaza Cellars informando, trayéndole los mejores vinos que se están presentando para los consumidores y en la tarde de hoy aquí en el Caribe Hilton para el trade. Me encuentro frente a una de las bodegas más conocidas de Portugal que hacen el famosísimo Oporto, en el Douro. Estoy con la Hugh Symington, la quinta generación, quinta generación de la familia Symington. Ciertamente estamos ante una familia que ha hecho muchísimo por el mundo del vino, que ha contribuido con su experiencia, con sus inversiones, con su incluso creando empleos pues para miles y miles de personas. Hugh, it's a pleasure to have you here. I was telling my viewers that we are with one of the, you know, premier families in the wine industry. You guys have been around for a number of years. Before we go deep into the two wines, the port and the dry wine that you have for us, tell me a little bit about your family, because it's not often that I get to sit down with someone who's, you know, has it in his blood.
So my family's been in Porto since 1882. There were a lot of Scottish and British families moving to Portugal originally because of shipping. People would bring bacalhau down from the North Sea into Portugal, and then they'd take wine back with them. And because of that, a lot of families set up. We were a little bit late to the show. But my grandfather arrived in 1882, my great-great-grandfather arrived in 1882, began working for Graham's originally, and in 1908 he began working with Dow's, and that's been with our family ever since.
Great. We were talking off camera. I was telling you a little bit about my blog, and you were telling me about, you know, that I gave you my card, had a little bit of wine, and you said that you yourself have been in the wine industry for a number of years, and you know, everything has to have a little bit of wine. Tell me about you in a personal capacity. How long have you been in the wine industry involved directly?
So I grew up in Oporto. I grew up in the wineries and in the vineyards. I've been doing harvests since a young age. As soon as I was old enough to actually go into the winery and help out or in a laboratory, I was doing that. Once I graduated from school, I had a little bit more time to do that, and I did a number of full harvests. And I've actually been working in the wine world properly for 2 years now for our U.S. importer based in San Francisco.
Great, great. So tell us a little bit about the two wines we have. We have a dry wine and a port. What can we expect of the Postscriptum 2017 Douro?
So the Postscriptum is a project we started 20 years ago with a Bordeaux winemaker, Bruno Prats, whose family used to own Chateau Costes Tournel. So this is a very Bordeaux-style wine that we produce with our grapes in the Douro Valley. This, as I say, you can liken it to a Bordeaux wine. Torriga Nacional and Torriga Franca are the two classic port varieties, and those are the two grapes that go into this wine in about a half and half ratio. Torriga Nacional is very relatable to Cabernet Sauvignon, while Torriga Franca brings along the freshness, the aromas that you get from Merlot.
All right, so let's taste together. Cheers, Hugh. It's a pleasure to have you on the show. Let's see what we have here. I love the nose. It's very restrained. It's a very old world. It definitely tells the story of the earth, you know, the soil. But you get that jamminess, that good fruit that you know it's going to be very clear, very vibrant. So silky. There's the black cherry, the red fruit. It's fresh. It feels very clean. It's got some herbs. Really coats the palate. I love the fact that it's only 14% alcohol nowadays, especially on this part of the world. Wines tend to be way too alcoholic. What do you get here?
I agree with what you've just said, and I think this is a testament to the winemaker's ability to control the incredibly ripe grapes that he's harvested in the Douro Valley, one of the driest and hottest regions in the world. And create a wine that, as you say, isn't too overly tannic or overly extracted.
I love the fact that right at the end and on the finish, I have this sort of nuttiness, hazelnut, even, you know, dry fruit component, like fig or like hazelnut. It's lovely. I mean, it's the same grapes that you used to make the port with, right?
Correct. Same grapes, same vineyards.
Fantastic. I love this wine. In terms of wine food pairing, let's say that I show up at your house one day and I say, Hugh, I brought you a Postscriptum 2017. What would you pair it with?
I might go for a traditional Portuguese dish like a pork dish or something like that, or alternatively anything with beef or something like that, or a pasta, anything. I think this wine is so light and easy drinking that it could really be paired with a number of things.
It's a fantastic wine. Here in Puerto Rico, we eat a lot of pork, and for Christmas, we eat this massive, beautiful, giant roasted pork. I think this would go very well with pork. Let's go into the Porto. Let's go here.
So this is a tawny style port. In port, we have two main styles, ruby and tawny. Rubies tend to be a little younger and a little bit more fruit forward. Whereas tawnies have seen a number of years aging in smaller barrels, a lot of oxidation going on there, and you end up with dried fruit flavors. In the Dows in particular, you get a lot of orange peel and nuttiness.
I love here the pit. You also have the stem of the fruit. There's that raisiny quality to it. The cherry, macerated cherries, licorice. There's a hint of clove, spice. It's fantastic. I love it. Can you eat with port?
Absolutely. Ideally, these wines would be paired with a dessert. Tawny ports pair incredibly well with creamier desserts, or such as a creme brulee, a pastel de nata, the classic Portuguese tart, custard tart, or with cheese. Even fruit tarts, things like that, go incredibly well with this.
It's fantastic. I mean, beautiful, beautiful. I thank you, Hugh, for the opportunity. I know you got to take care of the clients here. Oh, my God. Very, very good. Are there any new projects, anything that you want to share with our audience, any new labels, anything that we can expect in the coming years from the Symington family?
Well, actually, the Dow's 10, 20, 30, and 40-year-olds have just been released in this new bottle. It may be something new to the people here because it's only been in the market for about 6 months now. And we're really excited with this refresh of the brand, bring a little bit of a sort of a more modern feel to it while still serving it in a classic vintage port bottle.
Last question, and I know you've probably been asked this 1,000 times, but I get to ask it. What's your favorite thing about the wine industry?
Well, for me, the family is the most important part. Having grown up in a family in the wine industry, having those people around me and the passion around me has really sort of imparted that to me. And I have to say, talking to people here, everybody feels the same way. They all have a passion for this wine, and so many people have got into it through family.
Is this your first time in Puerto Rico?
First time in Puerto Rico.
Well, we certainly hope it's not the last. Thank you so much.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you so much, amigos. Esto estamos ante ciertamente una de las familias más importantes de Portugal, del Oporto, la familia Symington. He hablado con Hugh Symington, que es la quinta generación de la familia que trabaja unos grandísimos Oportos y un vino seco, que es el Postscriptum, que se vende muy bien aquí en Puerto Rico. Seguiremos informando desde el Fine Wine. Muchas gracias, Hugh. Salud. Será hasta la próxima. Chao, chao. Gracias.